another week on Cartoon.
Good morning!
Good morning, Uncle Grandpa Skeleton. Good morning to all. Another week on Cartoon. Full of smiles, cries, illusions and disillusions. A fly got stuck in Sumo's ear. It was Jake's birthday and he ate the cake in 4 bites. Many talked on the phone.
Over and out.
Rigby played video games. Steven opened the water tap. A bird made a nest out of garbage. Mr. Goss had a shower and we saw him without his tank top for the first time. And the biggest ice cream cup was inaugurated, but it melted in seconds. Another week on Cartoon.
Oh, it hurts so much.
Maybe you should take the day off.
Okay.
To get the day off, Lars pretended to have back pain, so Steven had to take his place. To learn the job, he was shown a VHS.
What is it? It's like a DVD shaped like a box, and it'll tell you everything you need to know.
Donuts at the Big Donut. They make the world go round. A treat when you are down. Donuts.
At first, it seems like a normal song, but I can assure you that it's the catchiest song in the world. And I bet you that by the end of this episode, you two are going to walk down the street singing
Donuts at the Big Donut. They make the world go round.
This week, Gumball woke up in a bad mood and wouldn't stop complaining about everything.
There's too much food in the fridge!
I think that just one thing he was right in complaining about.
Use the sausage for the eyebrows instead of the mouth, so my breakfast face looks mildly alarmed instead of smiling.
Listen, Gumball, your dish would look like this in the real world. I want to see what's the difference between using the sausage as an eyebrow or as a mouth. Yeah, you were right, Gumball. This is clearly a happy face, and this one is the face to put in this situation.
My nipples are purple!
And I thought that if we also wanted to add glasses, we could use...
Donuts! Donuts!
Sorry, I can't stop singing this song.
The donut fever's fried my soul!
The main characters get all of our attention and admiration. That's why the supporting characters have all the right to be this angry. Almost no one pays them any attention, but I do. So, the nominees for the favorite supporting character of the week are the cactus with a mustache, the muscled librarian, the boat head man, the UFO head man, and this little one who simply remained sitting while the other was doing push-ups. And the winner is Little One, our favorite supporting character of this week. Today, in Analyzing Stuff, let's see how the cartoons have decorated their houses. Rigby and Mordecai have pictures of Papaleta because they live in his house at the staff room of the Big Donut. They have posters of Millionaire Tiger and Amatista. At Gumball's, they have a sad clown. Jerry is so small that he uses a postage stamp as a poster. At Jeff's, it seems they like zebras because they have zebra paintings and zebra cushions. And Tronquitos has a painting of pyramids and a green apple. That painting reminds me of a similar one I have at home. Since we're talking about pictures, I want to show you my favorite one. This photograph I took of a tree with a nine shape.
So awesome!
And now that I think about it, it also has the shape of a...
Donuts! Donuts!
And talking about...
Donuts!
Steven learned a lot of secrets at the Big Donut in his working day.
You mean you don't make them here?
No, not since the accident.
To know what happened in that accident is one of the mysteries of the week. Like knowing the reason why Darwin's feet are censored, or why Jerry, being so smart, hasn't realized yet he should move his bed further from the hall to stop Tom bothering him. Or why Amatista, who, as we can see here, has 5 fingers, in this scene when she crosses her arms, has only 4. Or to understand the reason why so many characters drank coffee, but no one had it with...
Donuts! Donuts!
But to understand the reason why Uncle Grandpa opens his RV to end up living from its side, breaking everything, it's without doubt our Wixtery. We are getting closer to Finn. No, not that Finn. I mean the Finn.
Finn? Finn this!
I think we all learned a very important lesson today.
It's true, Gumball. Let's see. What have we learned this week? That Mr. Gus wakes up at 7 and Gumball at 9. That you can go inside a TV set. That it's better to use sausages as mouth and not as eyebrows. That even the most innocent characters can turn into monsters if they get angry. That we can't ever trust Pizza Steve or anyone who offers you special French fries. And that because of an accident, they don't do anymore.
Donuts at the big donut. They don't do them anymore. Your body can explode.
And all of this happened this week on Cartoon.
Alright, time to stay away from Starla the easy way. With television. Click.